दो फिल्में मुझे हर हाल में देखनी थी टोरंटो में, मियाज़ाकी की द बॉय एंड द हेरन और एवा डुवर्नी की ओरिजिन। काफी पर्सपेक्टिव ऑल्टरिंग एक्सपीरियंसेस दोनों। यस, आई वॉच्ड बोथ। Hey all, welcome back to my channel. I have just returned from Toronto and I would like to briefly discuss the movies I watched there. I plan to go into detailed discussions once the films become available aap sab ke liye. But for now, here are the short versions. Aaj, let's talk about Anjana Ellis' starrer origin, adapted from Isabel Wilkerson's book Caste, The Origins of Our Discontent, written and directed by Eva DuVernay. The movie begins with the reenactment of the moment 17-year-old Trayvon Martin was murdered in Florida. Understandably, the murder sparked uproar, protests. However, our story then shifts to Isabel, a Pulitzer Prize-winning, LV and Birkin-toting, celebrated black female author who isn't sure what her next literary frontier should be. She's heard about the killing, but is preoccupied with significant events in her personal life to write about the incident when someone suggests it as her next project. But soon her perspective changes and she decides that simply writing about a single act of hatred will not be sufficient, that addressing racial injustices alone is not enough. Instead, she wants to delve into the concept of caste. According to Isabel, racism is the primary lens to understand everything that's insufficient. What ails humanity and has for ages are the actual arbitrary hierarchies established by groups of individuals. These social contexts differ in each country, but their objective is the same: to concentrate various forms of social and economic power in the hands of a select few. Caste. As she explores these caste divisions globally, examining white supremacy in the USA, the Holocaust in Germany, and the outlawed yet prevalent caste system in India, filmmaker Eva DuVernay blends different forms and genres to reveal a narrative of human suffering and injustices and their global connective thread that many of us have chosen to ignore.
All over the place.
You know, at times, the movie enters the documentary zone, particularly when Dr. Suraj Yengde, a prominent award-winning Indian scholar and activist, appears as himself, aiding Isabel's understanding of caste in India during her visit to Delhi. When a researcher shows her the name Rohit Vemula written on a piece of paper, Eva ensures that we take note of that name. She's subconsciously imprinting the visual of those letters. The documentary vibe is different, but it's not bad. Origin primarily seems designed for an American movie-going audience, one that may have some knowledge of Hitler's actions in Germany, but lacks an understanding of caste, particularly as it extends globally, especially in India. The audience's reactions in the movie theater I was in confirmed this. With cinematographer Matthew J. Lloyd, Eva doesn't shy away from filling her frames with shots of toilets as Dalit men prepare for their manual scavenging jobs, swathing each other in oil. It's not a pretty sight, nor does it aim to be. Again, through the real-life experiences of Isabel, the film seems to assess caste around the world to help American audience better comprehend injustices around them. Honestly, and I'm not being facetious here, I believe Nitesh Tiwari was attempting something similar with Bawal. Two people traveling to a part of the world they know little about, gaining perspective that helps them become better citizens of their own country. However, thankfully in Origin, while Eva takes the cinematic liberty of recreating many historical scenes, making us feel like we're in the room witnessing some horrific events unfold, she never inserts her characters or herself as characters in the story. It's true that we often assess others' misfortunes based on our own lived experiences and wonder how different our lives could have been if we were on the receiving end. In this movie, though, it allows the audience to have that experience, those thoughts, as opposed to the characters in Bawal, who actively just were participating in everything on screen while we were watching from the sidelines, excluded from the catharsis. When Origin releases, we will sit down and discuss it further, hopefully by the end of this year, not sure. Until then, can we please all marvel at the casting? How a literal non-actor, Professor Gaurav J. Pathania, resembles Dr. Ambedkar so closely, seeing him in a gigantic close-up, smiling, waving, paving the way for a free people in a newly independent nation riddled with problems, gave me goosebumps. He's so good. So as an adaptation, Origin is unlike most others. The lines between fiction and dramatic recreation are deliberately blurred, like I'd mentioned earlier, perhaps to make Eva DuVernay's personal feelings towards caste more accessible, without shouting her views down at the audience through the screen, as was the case with the well-intentioned but ultimately unsuccessful Anek last year. There are actors portraying historic figures, but there are also real people sharing their personal experiences with systemic injustices. Eventually, this film is extremely approachable, albeit a tad schematic. Neither Isabel nor Ava are providing solutions. But in a world where manual scavenging abhi bhi hoti hai, critical race theory American classrooms se nikali ja rahi hai, neo-Nazi group khule mein murche kar rahe hain, a recap of how we have reached the point we are at today is as necessary as it is shameful. So, on a scale of 1 to 10, Origin is 20,000 किताबें एक रात में नाजी जलाते हैं इस मूवी के एक सीन में, ये कहकर कि इंटेलेक्चुअल्स नहीं चाहिए हमें जर्मनी में. देख लो, आज YouTube कमेंट्स में जब इंटेलेक्चुअल बोलकर कोई ट्रोल करने की कोशिश करता है, ये सेंटिमेंट कहाँ मिरर हुए हैं हिस्टोरिकली, कैसे दुनिया में फैशिज्म के तार जुड़े हुए हैं. नहीं, बाकी और कौन से रिव्यूज आ रहे हैं फ्रॉम माय टाइम एट टिफ जानने के लिए सब्सक्राइब कर लो चैनल को. वी आर सो वेरी क्लोज टू 100,000. कैन यू इवन बिलीव इट? माय नेम इज सुचारिता. थैंक यू फॉर स्टॉपिंग बाय.